Hey everyone, Sean here, and welcome back to another review featuring the HBO series The Last of Us. And today I'm going to be going over episodes 4 and 5, kind of, you know, lumping it together once again, like I did with 1 and 2, just because of the overall nature that was between 4 and 5. It felt like, you know, they're pretty much like together. It was kind of like a two-parter kind of thing going on with that little bit of the saga, right, or arc, or whatever you want to call it. And this is like pretty much featuring, you know, you kind of guessed it, with Henry and Sam, right? So I think you kind of see that with the episode previews and such like that. Even like hinted at stuff like that here and there. So that is essentially, you know, the sort of chapter pretty much revolving around those two. And then of course the sort of the evolving relationship between Joel and Ellie. As you can tell already, I'm going to be talking about story stuff already throughout the video, so if you haven't watched 4 and 5 already, go ahead and check it out. Let me say right away, even with that, I was able to really enjoy the episode. There was just all other things that were really cool, other than some nitpicky things, I believe. And I think it was just a great episode. Well, 5, I mean, and 4 was kind of, you know, a little more on the meh side in comparison to the other episodes so far, anyway. But we'll get into that more later on. But that's like the basic sort of gist of it overall. 5 was really good. The 4th one was kind of like the bridge getting there. So, like, literally, right? So, but anyway, that is essentially the nature of it. So, if anyone has not checked it out already, go ahead and check out those two episodes or whatever episode you need to catch up to, right? So, all right. So the story pretty much, you know, for 4 and 5, like I said, it revolves around Henry and Sam. And Henry is the older individual. He's the sort of collaborator between the Resistance and, I guess, the Fedra. Yeah, and he had like a bit of a go back and forth type of thing going on between himself, a friend, and of course Sam, of course, because he's doing this all for Sam, I believe, in order to survive. He had some like info and all that stuff about what's going on underground, because the story behind that is that the infected were all pushed to the underground by Fedra. So in a way, they had control of the city, and so they had control over the people of that city. I think it was Kansas or something like that. So they had control of the city, and they, over time, like 20 years or something like that, whatever, they did some nasty things. So naturally, they were, you know, building some sort of like rebellion or resistance over time. And when there was a chance to strike, then, you know, they you know, took over, and essentially they won at some point, and you know, they took over the city essentially, and so thus the Resistance became the rulers rather than than Fedra, right? But then, during of all this time, Henry didn't agree to, you know, to essentially didn't agree with the principles, right, of, especially, you know, with the current leader, Kathleen or Kathy or whatever her name is. I don't blame him for it. You know, she's kind of messed up in the head and stuff like that. And I definitely can see why Henry would want to run away from a group with her in it, and you know, take his little brother along with him. I think one of the huge changes with these characters is that I believe Sam wasn't deaf from the video game, but he is deaf here. So as a means of communicating with anyone else, you know, he has a little special drawing board, and then he writes something, he can reset it by, you know, it's like that special plastic thing, and then you have the black thing in the back, right? You can kind of like write something, and then when you pull the sheet back, it essentially erases like whatever you wrote, and, you know, you can write stuff over and over again. So it's kind of cool, you know, pretty smart, you know, to carry that around so that he can communicate with all the others, right? Now, so anyways, with all the little in-betweens and whatever, you know, try not to. I'm not trying to go deep into those too much, but Henry basically had a falling out with the resistance group because he just wants to get away from all that stuff. She essentially wants him dead. He's like the most wanted man in Kansas City or whatever. And that's essentially the story, right? That's why she's chasing him down along with another person, right? Which is the doctor. And, that's why we get to see him during episode 4 with the interrogation scene. And that scene was kind of, I know I'm kind of like jumping all over the place, but that one was like the weirdest sort of thing about episode 4 was that they're trying to, in a weird way, like kind of like use that time to provide Kathleen a platform of sorts to kind of like represent herself of why she is here, why is she here as a character, right? Because she's a brand new character for the show. She never appeared in a video game, but the group is based off of, you know, the people within the video game, right? But Kathleen or whatever is the new character, and then she has a bunch of like henchmen and whatever, whatever you want to call them, soldiers or whatever, under her command and stuff like that. And of course, I don't think any of those characters have ever appeared in the video game, of course, so there's that. But anyways, they try to give her a platform and a reason as to why we should, like, you know, sympathize with her in a way. But really, I think from the very get-go, they are just big piles of shit. I'm just gonna say it like that, man. It is what it is, man. And just even like, I felt that scene, a lot of those minutes were kind of wasted because it's like they're trying to make her sympathetic, but at the same time, in a grand scheme of things, you just know that she is an absolute big piece of shit, and there is something wrong with her head, right? There's something going on in her head. And especially by the time in the fifth episode, there is no redeeming factor for her. Like she is a full-on villain, right? In a world full of villains, just an absolute villain. So there is nothing that really could redeem her as a character that can be humanized with or some whatever, right? It's just, she is just as bad as the infected. She is the monster, right? She is, you know, kind of like them, kind of like that. Anyway, so yeah, I felt like that those minutes were wasted, and that could have been used for more on, getting to know Henry and Sam in a way. Or of course, this episode 4 was also a sort of the building blocks of sorts for Ellie and Joel, right? And let's go back to the beginning though. It was nice to see them kind of like talking in the truck or whatever, and then there was a scene with Ellie pulling the magazine, right? That lovely scene from the video game where she opens up a gay porn mag, right? And even has the line of, you know, why the pages are sticky, you know, how you walk around with that thing, that sort of thing, you know, going on. That was really nice, actually. Although it's kind of like weird because, you know, we were coming off of the episode, that very wholesome like episode of Bill and Frank, right? But then you have this porn mag, you know, in the very next episode. So it's like they deviate and then they go back to the thing. It's like, so the tones are quite different if you want to put them together like that. But it's still nice nonetheless to see that scene just for the sake of, like, you know, kind of like that fan service for the players, right? Like myself, you know. And then she throws the magazine away. Adios, that whole thing, right? And they kind of just have a chat, you know, in the car about Tommy, which is of course new because, you know, there's a lot of deviation from the whole Tommy and Joel stuff, right? So the whole reason of Joel doing this in the first place too, not only to take Ellie, but he wants to find his brother. So that's a big addition for this show, deviating from the video game. So that's one thing I wanted to kind of point out here, if I haven't so already. But anyways, they get to the bridge, right? The underpass of the bridge, of course. That's why I brought up the bridge thing earlier. And then there was a road blockage of sorts. You know, there's all these cars kind of just blocking the way, and I guess it was not a good passage for the trucks, so they had to go around and through the city, and that's where they meet some of the rebellion, right? And the rebellion kind of faking, you know, somebody being injured and needing help. Joel saw through them right away, so he drove straight through rather than going back. But I guess what else could you do, I guess, except to go forward, you know? But they're getting shot at. The spike strips got them, and then the truck crashes into this like laundromat or whatever, the coin laundry, and they essentially lose the truck, right, with all those supplies, unfortunately. But they essentially have a gunfight with some of the rebellion. There are two of them, and Joel, you know, was shooting at them while Ellie went for cover or was hiding, as told by Joel, go through the hole and stuff like that, and then eventually shot two of them. And then there was, I believe, one more or two or something like that. But anyways, one of the younger members came in and tried to choke out Joel with the shotgun, right? You know, pinning him to the ground, stuff like that. Managed to take him down, right? And has him in a hold with the shotgun and everything, or whatever it was, with the rifle, choking him down and everything. But then Ellie, who was still hiding in the hole, you know, had the pistol from the previous episode, right? Just a like a Walther or something like that, some sort of small pistol that you see in World War II or something like that. That's what it looks like to me. Or like it's like the James Bond gun, right? And then they basically brought it out, you know, finally unleashes the gun to save Joel. And essentially, you know, the young guy kind of starts to beg for his life, and then Joel doesn't buy it. So tells Ellie to, you know, go back to the hole. You don't want to see this kind of thing. And then takes out the dude with the knife that tries to give away, because, you know, saying, hey, you know, I'm not armed or whatever, you know, trying to survive, but does not meet the good end of the stick, gets stabbed. And that is essentially it for that little fight. And then after that, you know, the whole interrogation scene happens with Kathleen and the doctor, who was helping out Henry and Sam in the first place, does a whole speech, or there's that whole thing in the first place, trying to, you know, put her in a platform of, where to have you thinking, right? Is she a good guy or a bad guy or whatever? But she's a fucking bad guy. I don't fucking care, you know. And basically, she then hears about Joel and Ellie, just outsiders, right, taking out the members, right, and pretty much is like, well, or pretty much is told that, oh, the doctor can't help, you know, revive any of these individuals. And then for some reason, Kathleen just kills the doctor, right, which is a great idea in the world of post-apocalyptic proportions. Just take out a doctor just because you can't take care of these individuals are dead. Why not the rest of them, right? If anyone gets infected or not infected, but like, you know, gets injured or breaks an ankle or something, I don't know. No, we don't need a doctor anymore. Just, you know, just take some help, just like that. I guess she doesn't want any more rats or something like that, so just takes them out. So I guess there's that. She takes out the doctor. And once essentially Joel and Ellie kind of dead or captured or whatever, and then along with that get Henry while at that. There's also like kind of like a thing going on, I guess, with the second in command or the captain of the soldiers, and of course the commander, right? So or the head of the resistance. Whether it's just like a good relationship or maybe a romantic relationship, who cares? There's something going on with these two, right? Because he always kind of like tries to be rational, and then she is like an absolute kind of like a psycho, right? Amongst the two, especially when he tries to be like, you know, we have a lot of men, you know, just out there right now. We can't do this right now. But she's like, this is our number one priority. Blah blah blah, like, you know, that sort of thing. I think that's in episode 5. I'm probably like getting all this stuff mixed up. But in episode 4, while they're searching for who killed these guys or whatever, their men, they find that crater, right? And it's like not a big crater, but a noticeable crater nonetheless, left by what you assume to be, if you play the game, a bloater, right? So, like, you know, those big guys who throw the nasty spores or whatever, but I'm pretty sure they're not going to do that in this one because the spores don't really play a part for some reason here. I'm not sure why even still, but whatever. So they're probably going to do something different, maybe like throw like acid or something, or I don't know some sort of like mushroom bomb or something of sorts that will help spread the fungus or fungi, right? You know, taking over their bodies and stuff like that eventually or whatever. But anyways, that's what I would assume anyway that was associated with this crater. But then Kathleen's like, you know, keep this a secret. And in the second and the captain was just like, wait, are you sure? Like, yeah, I mean, you know, obviously you don't want to, you know, create panic or anything like that. But, you know, again, like, she's kind of like being that piece of shit, right? Because, you know, essentially, has she done that, right? I think they would have been better prepared for that kind of stuff. Like, you know, get a bigger weapon or something, or just be ready to just, like, be prepared to fight something big. But, of course, I don't know, she just wants to keep things her way, I guess, in her head. Maybe that was like the best thing to do for this kind of situation. By the way, it didn't pay off, right? In episode 5, because guess what? We eventually get there. But overall, though, you know, this was there were other scenes, right? This was kind of important because this was a building block for Joel and Ellie to start building their relationship as like kind of like a father and daughter sort of relationship, right? Or at least that's what Joel sees, right? Or feels, or starts to feel, in a way. And they, you know, went into hiding after the shootout. And instead of really getting mad at Ellie for holding a gun without his knowing, he actually apologizes for, you know, not being prepared enough or just put it into... Because, you know, he felt like he put them into the situation where Ellie has to pull out the gun and save him for once, right? So... that was his fault in his eyes, and you know what? I mean, that's he took it like a champ, right? So, wasn't too upset, and in fact, wanted to help give tips to Ellie how to hold the gun properly and stuff like that. You know, hold here or whatever, so that way when you know someone tries to shake the gun off of her hands, you know, won't come off so easily. And in fact, Ellie was like, "Whoa, that's so cool," or whatever. And, you know, pretty much like gives the gun to Ellie, and there's like a symbolization that, you know, their hands are clasped like this, they got each other's backs in battle, you know, that sort of thing. Like they, you know, trust each other, right, at that point. So they go hiding, right? They go hiding to this one of the big buildings and try to make camp for the night, try to sleep. Oh yeah, but along the way though, Ellie picked up got herself one of those pun books, tries to throw out puns along the way, and then Joel over time kind of like, you know, he didn't want to show it, but you know, he likes those sort of jokes, I guess. So, you know, you eventually get to see him start to giggle or laugh or whatever by the end of it. But there was that camping scene, of course, I kind of forgot about that, but there was one of those scenes where, you know, you get to see them like eat 20-year-old ravioli and kind of bond a little bit, and then we can go back to here where before they go to bed completely, she throws out one more joke, and then they all giggle and laugh or whatever eventually, and then eventually that's when the episode ends with Henry and Sam pointing their guns at them, you know, and then that's where that episode 4 ends. Episode 5 is where, of course, we get to know Henry and Sam a little more, you know, kind of why they were running away, what happened, and all that stuff, you know, get a just a bit of or enough backstory, I guess, to establish him as characters, why they're here and stuff like that. You know, he knows the city around enough, unlike Joel or whatever, so that's why they team up, right? And Joel and Ellie are kind of like the muscle, almost. Well, Joel, of course, but more or less, they can help protect Henry and Sam along the way. Although Henry has some sort of combat experience, I guess. But, you know, hey, if you look at Joel, he can tell. He even says himself, I think, that he can tell. He knows how to fight and stuff like that. They, in fact, even brought up the whole clicker thing, and there you go, right? So they fought the clickers and survived. Henry was more confident to stick with them to, you know, get through the city, through the tunnels, and then escape out at that. And as they go along, though, after they made their plan and everything, they start to kind of get along, right? Especially with Sam and Ellie, right? They're both kids still. So although Sam is 8, I think, and then Ellie is 14, so quite an age gap there, but they're still bonding quite quickly, right? They're still, you know, they're playing along. You know, Ellie's like the big sister essentially, and that was, you know, it was pretty cool. It was nice to see. And then Joel and Henry, over time, within that same span of time, you know, trusted each other, and it could have been potentially like, you know, like a four-man group almost, right? Like they could have been pretty tight-knit like that if had, you know, had to play along in their way by the end of it. But while getting there, you know, they saw this comic book, right? Or Ellie and Sam saw this comic book, and with the whole endurance survive thing, which Joel kind of used that, or Joel and Sam, or Henry used it as like a conversation sort of opener, or just like something for a conversation, you know. Anyways, along the way, they're playing around, and, you know, they get to, you know, they essentially get along, and then eventually they get to like the neighborhood, right, the suburbs, but then they were getting sniped down by one of the rebellion, or the resistance soldiers, who turns out to be just some old man who's, you know, he's a sniper, but according to Joel, he's bad at aiming or whatever. So, but he managed to pin them down for a little bit. But Joel managed to snuck his way around, got to the sniper, tries to just have him surrender, but the sniper doesn't want, you know, he wants to go out with the fight. And Joel had no choice but to shoot him down right then and there, knowing that he's gonna get killed anyway. So old man dies, the sniper dies, but then by the time he does so, he hears the radio. You know, you find out that he's part of the resistance because, you know, he has a radio and he can hear Kathleen's voice on the other side, or from the other side anyway. And then, you know, there's more, and not to mention, speaking of Kathleen, there was another scene within episode 5. She was like in the room or whatever, like when they were kids, in this old ass room, tells a story about, you know, how or what happened during their childhood. And, you know, her brother was like, you know, always trying to take care of, you know, her his sister, Kathleen, because, you know, things like, you know, she was scared of thunder or lightning and whatever. And so, blah blah blah, you know, it's okay, we're gonna be fine, we're in this box or whatever, so we're fine or whatever. And then, you know, they try to do that thing again with the humanizing thing, but in the end it's like, yeah, it's so weird because like there were scenes where from episode 4, I believe, Kathleen was like looking at the drawings left by Sam, because Sam was like drawing stuff as a way to distract from the situation of things, you know, as told by Henry, right? Like, you know, all this room is ugly, right? They're in that the attic to hide from the resistance, and this was during episode 4 or whatever, like the time of episode 4, and they were hiding out. Sam was drawing, right? And then Kathleen saw those drawings later on, along with the leftover canned food or whatever. And essentially, you know, saw those drawings, she's kind of like, you know, I guess like she has some like face of like, you know, like you know, some sort of like she cares about kids or whatever. But then, and then has a story with that shit or whatever with her brother in the room or whatever, with the captain too. So that's where more of that relationship shows with the captain and Kathleen, that they have, that they're pretty tight like that. He's loyal to her no matter what, you know, he and the rest of the guys have her back essentially. And back to here in the suburbs, the resistance catches up to them, and essentially is about to, you know, gun down Henry and stuff like that, and kill the rest of the kids, because Kathleen, you know, despite having all that stuff earlier, you know, in episode 4 and parts of 5, you know, she's like, oh, kids die too, right? Like all that shit. Like, what the fuck? Like, she is a complete psychopath. She is a complete crazy bitch. She deserves to die. And of course, right when she's, you know, loads up the pistol, right? Chambers the round. You hear that sound, right? The, you know, that menacing rumble, right? And you're just like, oh shit, man. Oh shit, man. But I thought it was just going to be the one bloater or something giant, right? But then you see like this explosion of, oh yeah, I mean, there's a truck right there. And then Joel shot the truck because, you know, the truck was clearing out the cars, you know, and then for Kathleen and everyone else behind that big truck. But Joel snipes him down, truck crashes into this house and then opened up the hole or something. And then, yeah. But it was with that reminiscing rumble. I was like, oh shit! And then the truck was like sinking down. Like, so it looks like it was about, like, I honestly it was gonna be like a infected, like giant kaiju kind of, not like a huge kaiju, but like, you know, like maybe 3 stories tall at most, or 20 stories or 2 stories tall, or whatever you want to say. A really big infected somehow, even though all infected are based off of humans, right? So it would be weird to have like a kaiju, because the mutated cordyceps can only infect humans, right? These mutated species can only infect humans, I believe, right? So it would be really weird but cool if they have a giant freaking cordyceps infected, right, of sorts, whether it's like a worm or some big old mutated human or something like that somehow. They were able to make the human grow or something like that with their fungi powers or whatever. But it wasn't just the bloater. It was just a huge army of infected. It turns out like Frederick didn't quite wipe them out. They just pushed them away from the city essentially. So that guy who was an informant to Henry turned out to be wrong. Very wrong. So he was kind of a piece of shit too, potentially, but he's dead, whatever. So anyways, there's a whole big explosion full of infected, and I was like, that was fucking radical, man. Freaking all those infected just running after running towards anyone, so including the resistance, right? And that's the infected sort of zombie action that, you know, people were looking for, I'm sure. And that I thought delivered, right? So that was fucking awesome. And then, so there was chaos along the way. And then of course, the moment we all been waiting for, the bloater, right? You can see kind of like that, the second sort of sound. And then, you see the blower coming out, just plowing through whatever stands in its way, including the captain, unfortunately. You know, told Kathleen to run. Captain did what he could, burns his magazine, throws out a pistol, but then blower didn't even care, rips his head off or face or whatever, just like that. He ripped him like a, I don't know, like a... like a little, like a pinata essentially, right? Just cardboard, nothing, right? Just rips him. And that was the end of the captain, man. That was like, I mean, of course it wasn't like up close or anything like that, but you can imagine, right? That this bloater doesn't care, brutal, you know? He got finished in Mortal Kombat, essentially. And then along the way, you know, Ellie tries to hide in the car, and there's a small clicker, I think, or something like that. Tries to go after her, but managed to escape, I think. But along the way, Henry and Sam were essentially getting overwhelmed by some of the infected, and then Joel tried to like snipe him out or whatever, but managed to escape, blah, blah, and then they get to the end, but then Kathleen was like, oh, you know, I got you, right? Like, you know, anything. But after all what she did, man, I wanted her gone. And especially with, there was that one more scene I forgot to mention, with the, one more interrogation or tries to find a rat, you know, to within the group of informants from Fedra, and essentially one of them told that the doctor, right, essentially the doctor has been cooperating with Henry all this time, despite having her say give them a fair trial, face jail time, told her soldiers they're out, man, take them out, you know. And so she is a complete piece of shit, a complete villain. All that humanizing shit was a waste of time. Maybe it's a red herring, but it's a complete waste of time to me. She's a complete piece of shit. But fortunately, she meets her end by one of the infected. It was the same clicker that went after Ellie. You know, personally for me, I wish it was a bloater. Rips her apart, you know. Just because she's an absolute piece of shit, I wanted a more of a radical way for her to get taken out. But, I mean, we got what we wanted, right? Or I got what I wanted still with Kathleen. I didn't like her. You know, she's a villain. She's written to be hated, right? So I didn't like her. The clicker got her. The small clicker got her. I wish they showed like a close-up of her getting ripped apart or something. Something, right? Like a little glimpse, right? Of the little clicker doing work, right? I mean, at least do one of the death animation scenes from the video game or something, you know, boom, or I don't know, something, right? Like a chest crush or something, or throat bite or something, or bite the neck, or I mean, you kind of see something going on, but I mean, I wish there was a little more satisfaction to that. But nonetheless, she's gone. She's like, I'm glad that she wasn't the one to like take out Henry or Sam or anything like that. See, honestly, I thought they were gonna use the humans to take out Henry and Sam. That would have been kind of horrible too, in a way, to show that, you know, not only the infected are a threat to this world, but the humans are as well. Even, you know, even in The Last of Us, right, the video game, they kind of lean on more towards the humans being harmful, and then the zombies were kind of just like the Cordyceps zombies were kind of just like a little more there than they are the main subject, right? Or the main theme, right? In the video game, they try to use the humans more as like they're the threat, they're the real monsters of this zombie world or whatever. But I thought here in the show, they're going to do like an equal amounts kind of thing, but oh, hell no, man. This is the Cordyceps' world, man. This is their world now, at least in this case anyway. And so they took out the resistance group entirely, pretty much. Maybe there could be one or two survivors or whatever. I don't know. Maybe they took off in the truck or something, but pretty much most of them, if not all of them, wiped out, including, of course, Kathleen, thankfully. I thank God she was not the one to take out Henry and Sam, right? And that, you know, I honestly thought that was going to happen, right? To use the humans to swap out the humans, or swap in the humans with the infected to take out Henry and Sam. But no, it was the Infected all the way, man. They are the threat to this world, and they are putting their foot down, essentially. So, unfortunately, yes, we get to the scene eventually with Sam being infected after all that stuff. You know, they're really bonding, right? They're reading through the comic book, Endurance, Survive, all that stuff. You know, they're doing that whole thing. And, you know, kind of like what happened with that little classroom thing before, the underground classroom. They're playing some more with the comic, right? And then Joel and Henry had that conversation, right? Like how redundant it is. It's a bad comic book in a way. It's very cheesy because it is redundant. You know, Endure and Survive, right? And then Joel and Henry were about to pretty much build trust, right? They're essentially going to be potentially the four-man team they were hoping for. But then, of course, I believe just like in the video game, Sam was bitten and turns on Ellie. But before that, though, I think this was a brand new scene, I believe. And they're, I guess, trying to like show that Ellie isn't quite, you know, the key to the cure for this, you know, for this infection, this fungi infection spread in the conventional way. Like, it's not like her blood is like the serum to like cure them all and like that. It's a very different way, unfortunately. You know, she cut her hand, tries to soak up the wound or infected wound with her blood. Unfortunately, it doesn't work. Sam is still, you know, he became infected and goes after Ellie, tries to rip her apart. Henry was just like, what the fuck is going on? Takes, I think, Joel's gun, and then boom, just had to take out his little brother, man. Completely distraught, just completely beyond just repair. It looked like it was going to, you know, shoot up Joel or Ellie or whatever. Just just beyond upset, beyond frustrated, beyond just angry, powerless, just could not do anything about his little brother. And instead, you know, he had nothing to live for, essentially, no purpose, and takes out his own life with the gun. So that was all gut-wrenching too, right? I wanted to say this was all well done. The fifth episode was like way more engaging, in my opinion, than episode four, despite the action and stuff like that. There was just stuff that I kind of killed the momentum for me in episode four, especially with the whole Kathleen thing, trying to be humanized and whatever, but you know. But the stuff with Joel, Ellie, Sam, Henry, and Sam, that was all good. You know, I felt that, right? Despite knowing, right, from the video game, that's really saying something of how well these episodes are done. This, I'm telling you, man, the HBO series being very much well done. And essentially, episode five wraps it up with Ellie and Joel burying Henry and Sam. And Ellie writes one last time on Sam's notepad or whatever, the special notepad, that, you know, despite promising trying to save Sam with the infection and all that stuff with her blood, they didn't work. And writes, I'm sorry, on the notepad and leaves it there on essentially their grave. So that was just a sad ending, despite knowing what happened and stuff like that from the video game. That was still sad. I felt it, man. I even felt the gut-wrenching stuff from all before in episode five, just because like you just don't know what they're gonna do with this show, right? Like, what's gonna happen and stuff like that. What's the bloater gonna do, right? You know, and that is pretty much it. You know, that wraps up episode five. That was well done, in my opinion. I mean, episode four wasn't still horrible, but out of all these episodes so far, I would say episode four will be the quote unquote weakest or the lowest rating one. You know, I mean, if I were to give it a rating from that one, it's still like a 7 out of 10, really. Like, it was still like well done. It's just like the some of the stuff that was provided here doesn't really add, or doesn't really like pay off in a way to me. It just kind of just like was there to waste time or fill in time. I kind of wish they did something a little different with the Kathleen scenes. Like, I don't know. I mean, I don't think they did too much of a good job with the humanizing stuff. It just you just know from the get-go that she is a piece of trash, right? And no matter what she says or what comes out of her mouth or came out of her mouth, you just know that she is a villain within the world of villains, right? It's not like she's trying to do all this to survive. She's just doing this all for just because she feels like the power, right? And maybe that should have been an aspect that should have driven, like she, like they show, like she is just like feels in control in a way, instead of just like trying to have us sympathize for her. But instead, why not just show us like how she feels about all this leadership, all she, you know, how she is taking all this in. So maybe like, maybe she, you know, just have her, you know, I mean, yeah, it would have been maybe a little more typical, but nonetheless, I felt like I was taken out of it a little bit when they're trying to do that with Kathleen. But anyways, despite all that, everything else was just really good. The action was really good. I think the tense moments were really well done. I think everything else was pretty good, right? So, especially with the Henry Sam stuff, I kind of wish a little more. I wish they showed a little more backstory on Henry and Sam, where they were coming from, really, how they were when they were kids, you know, that sort of thing. Especially with how Bill and Frank got this like big fucking episode, right? Why not give us a little bit of that at least, you know, for Henry and Sam, right? To give us even more of a tearjerker when they ended, right? So that would have been really nice, although all the more gut-wrenching, but you know, that would have enhanced the drama, you know, in this series, right? So I wish for a little more with Henry and Sam, but what we got here was still well done. I guess one more thing was I kind of hoped that the bloater was the one to take out Kathleen, but that would also mean the bloater would have to chase after Joel and Ellie. It would not make sense for the bloater to kind of just like, you know, rip her apart and then be like, ugh, and then just turns around and goes. Unless you know, they could have the bloater go after them, but then get shot from behind by the resistance or whatever, and then turns around, gets distracted, and then they can run away or something about like that. But I don't know. I kind of wish for Kathleen to meet a more satisfying end, right? Because of how much of a piece of shit she is to in my eyes anyway. Whatever, man. Despite that, I think I'm gonna give this episode like a solid 9 out of 10, I think, for episode 5, just because like all that stuff was pretty cool, man. Like, you know, the bonding with Henry, Sam, Joel, and Ellie, the action, how the infected were just boom, just explode into the scene, the bloater. You know, you do wish for more, so you know, so bit of a minus points for that a little bit, but mostly a nitpick. I wish for a satisfying ending with Kathleen, right? More satisfying ending, so on and so forth. So, but yeah, episode 5 much better than episode 4, and I'm definitely continuing to enjoy this. So that's all I can say about The Last of Us thus far. I'm definitely wanting to enjoy this more. I think we're pretty much like almost halfway through. If not, we are halfway through, right? So, because we're about to get into episode 6, and I believe it's out of 12. So we're getting there. We're getting there. So hopefully they can tell a good tale within the next 6 episodes, because we really need to see how Joel and Ellie really evolve together, right? As a whole, as a unit, right? And see how Joel sort of evolves as like a more father figure towards Ellie, and then have it all, and hopefully have all that pay off by part 2 and all that stuff. We'll definitely have to wait and see. So, but anyways, 7 out of 10 for episode 4, and 9 out of 10 for episode 5 anyway. Oh, maybe 9.5. I don't know. I mean, I think these ratings don't really matter. I would like to rather rate this whole thing as a whole, but why not? I mean, this is a little bonus thing. So anyways, great episodes despite the little nitpicks and shortcomings and stuff like that. And I'm definitely hoping to enjoy more of it. Hopefully that momentum sort of keeps going. There are some little spots, there's some little gaps of like, what? Like, why did he do that? You know, that sort of thing. I'll let you guys go, but thank you very much. If you have any comments about The Last of Us so far, leave them down below. I mean, you know, are you guys brand new to The Last of Us? Is this your first time sort of interacting with The Last of Us, with this drama series? Are you guys planning to play the video game after finishing up The Last of Us? Or, you know, are you guys coming from the other way around? Have you played the video game? What do you guys think of the drama series so far? You know, anything relating to that and relating to Last of Us, leave them down below. Don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, you know the drill. And I really do appreciate you guys. So I'll try to buy the time for, you know, reviewing the rest of the episode somehow. Maybe it might be a two-parter again. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. So either way, thank you very much. And hope to see you all in the next one. Sean out.